Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to use a USB flash drive with your Mac. MacMost is supported by more than 500 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you can use a USB flash drive like this one as external storage for your Mac to store files, archive things, or transfer files between Macs or between Macs and Windows computers. First, you want to make sure that you have a USB drive that will work with your Mac. So older Macs use USB-A, which is this rectangular connection you see here. Newer Macs use a smaller USB-C connector. Now, this device actually slides, so it will have USB-C coming out the other end. You can see how that looks different. So you want to make sure you get the right connection for the Mac that you have, or get a flash drive like this one that has both connections. If you're mismatched, you're going to need an adapter. So for instance, if you have an older USB-A drive, then you can simply use a USB hub to connect it or get a converter. But these things are pretty cheap, so a lot of times it may just be worthwhile to just buy a new one that fits your current Mac. So once you plug the drive in, you should see it appear in a number of places. In any Finder window, it should appear on the left under Locations. If you see nothing under Locations like that, move your cursor over the word Locations, and to the right you should see a Show button, and then it will show everything there. In this case, I have five locations. The first one is my main computer level. The second one is my internal hard drive. Then I have two external hard drives. And then finally, there is the USB drive that I just plugged in. I'll also see it here on the desktop. Now if you don't see the drive appear on the desktop, it could be that you have that option turned off. Go to Finder Preferences and then go to General and then look for External Disks under Show These Items on the Desktop. I prefer not to have those shown on the desktop, but a lot of people do. And here you can see my two external drives plus the USB flash drive. You can also always see the drives that are attached by going to the main computer level. I showed you here, there's a link to it right there. You could also choose Go and then Computer to go to the same location, and there you'll see the drive. So to see the contents on the drive, all you need to do is select any one of these. I could double click on this one, I could double click here, and I could just select this one here in the Finder and it'll show me what's on the drive. In this case, there are no files there. Now I can move files there just like I can to a folder that's on my internal drive. All I need to do is drag and drop. So for instance, I could go to my Documents folder and I could select a file in here and drag that onto the icon there on the desktop, or I can drag it onto the listing here in the sidebar. Either way, we'll put it there. And if I go to look at the contents now, I'll see that file's there. Also, if I leave this window open but open up a new Finder window, I can navigate to another location here and drag a file there as well. Notice that since it's a separate drive, dragging and dropping automatically makes a copy. It won't remove the file from the first drive to put it onto the second drive. It copies it there. That's a safety precaution. But if you wanted to actually have it move the file, you can drag it. And as you're dragging, you can see the cursor there has a little green plus arrow. But if I hold the Command key down, that goes away. And now that file is going to be moved. You'll see I even get a warning here because that file happens to be an iCloud drive. And it will give me a warning saying this is going to take it off of iCloud drive if I move it and not copy it to the USB flash drive. To delete files from the flash drive, you can do it just like you do with files on your internal drive. You can drag them to the trash can in the dock, or you could select them and use File and then Move to Trash. Command Delete is the shortcut for that. However, note that when you move something to the trash, it's still in the trash, so you're not going to get back any space on the drive. So throwing a lot of files into the trash won't free up space. What you need to do then is go to the trash, control click on it and choose Empty Trash, or in the Finder go to Finder Empty Trash. That will remove all the files in the trash across all of your different drives. So any internal drive files you put into the trash will also be deleted at that point. If you want to just delete the file immediately, you can select it and notice if I go to File, Move to Trash, but I hold the Option key down, it changes to Delete Immediately. The shortcut would just be Option Command Delete. That would skip the trash for those files and get rid of them. So when you first get a USB flash drive, you probably want to format it or at least check the formatting. To do that on Mac, run Disk Utility. I'm going to use Spotlight, Command Space, and search for Disk Utility and run that app. Then I'm going to see it here on the left. Now what I want to do is change the view from Show Only Volumes to Show All Devices. Once I do that, I can clearly see the device itself instead of just the volume on it. By selecting the device itself, I have the most options and I can actually reformat it rather than just erasing it. To reformat it, you use the Erase button here. And then you can select a new name for the drive and also a format. There are many different formats to choose from. APFS is the current Apple format and has been around for a couple of years now. macOS Extended is the older format. So if you need to use this drive on an older Mac running a system prior to macOS Mojave, then you may want to select this one. Otherwise, APFS is fine. If you choose Encrypted, you'll be asked to provide a password, and then the only way to access the files on this drive would be to use that password. Be sure to remember that password, because if you forget it, those files are gone forever. Now if you want to use this drive on your Mac and also on Windows computers, then you need to choose XFAT or FAT. FAT is the older format for Windows. Just about any Windows machine in operation now can read XFAT, so that's probably fine. But it's easy these days to share files with other computers using cloud services or networking. So using USB flash drives to transfer files from one machine to the other isn't as common as it used to be. So for most users, if you're just using the drive on a Mac, use APFS or, if you have to, macOS Extended. Now when you buy a new flash drive, they usually come formatted for Windows by default. The manufacturers just assume that you're going to have Windows. So if you're only going to use it on Macs, you probably want to reformat it for Macs before you do anything with it. Now while you can name your drive when you erase it and reformat it, you can also rename it in the Finder. So I can select the drive here at the computer level or on the desktop and then hit the return key to rename the drive, just like I would rename a file. Now when you want to remove your USB flash drive from your Mac, it's important to tell your Mac you're going to do that first. You can do that here in the Finder sidebar. You can see a little eject button next to all of my external drives. So I can simply click that. Also, if you control click on the icon here in the Finder or here on the desktop, you've got the option to eject from there. Another location is with the drive selected either here or here. You can go to File and then Eject, and notice that the keyboard shortcut is simply Command E. You do that and you make sure the icon completely disappears and the sidebar item is gone before you physically remove it from the computer. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.